fellow scientists, I'm Kiana, the lab technician here, normally behind the scenes at RayBiotech. Today, I'm going to walk you through one of our most popular kits and the gold standard in protein detection, the sandwich ELISA assay. This is a single-plex sandwich assay format, meaning the capture antibody is going to capture an antigen. A bioethylated detection antibody is going to detect that antigen. Horseradish peroxidase is going to find that bioethylation. The amount of antigen present in the sample will be directly proportional to the amount of HRP. At that point, we will add our colorimetric developer, TMB. The chemical reduction will cause a pigment change from clear to blue. That blue intensity will be directly related to the concentration of antigen in the sample. To stop the reaction, we add stop solution, which is dilute sulfuric acid. These kits have been featured in over 4,000 publications and come with our risk-free guarantee, meaning if you encounter a problem with one of our ELISA kits and our technical support team cannot resolve it, we will issue you a credit, refund, or replacement. Ask our technical support team how you can receive your first trial ELISA kit for $99. We are not an ELISA reseller. All our kits are manufactured in the USA, right here in Peachtree Corners, Georgia. So when you buy an ELISA kit from RayBiotech, you're receiving the fastest service and support possible. This video is part of our visual manual series. Everything I say here can also be found on your digital manual card by following this link. It will take you to the manual, or you can pull it up on our website where you can download it for free. On our website, you will also find the list of previous kit citations for that target. We are going to demonstrate human IL-18. Interleukin-18 is one of a number of pro-inflammatory cytokines, the activities of which appear to be species-specific. You can read more about it in the manual introduction. As this is a demonstration for all of our ELISA kits, we are going to start with the material section. First is a 96-well ELISA plate pre-coated with anti-IL-18 antibody. We are quantifying the absolute concentration, so we have two lyophilized standard vials of IL-18 and two vials of anti-IL-18 biotin-labeled antibody. Detection enzyme is horseradish peroxidase, commonly known as HRP. HRP is paired with light-sensitive substrate TMB. That reaction is stopped with dilute sulfuric acid or stop solution. You have two concentrated assay diluents and one concentrated wash buffer. ADA is only used with cell culture samples. We recommend using our wash buffer even if you already have one of your own. Plate seals are used for each incubation. Additional materials your home court lab will need. First and foremost is a microplate reader and a plate rocker. In case of an emergency, you can use plastic wrap as a covering. To blot any excess liquid, use absorbent cushion paper. And you will need any essential lab supplies. Deionized water will be used to dilute concentrated buffers. Most ELISA labs will have a plate washer. We will demonstrate hand washing if this is not an option. Before we start, we are going to prepare our reagents. Concentrated buffers are diluted with deionized water. If using cell culture samples, you only need to dilute ADB. If using serum and plasma samples, dilute both ADA and ADB. Dilute wash buffer. Even if you already use your own, we recommend using ours. To determine the absolute concentration of antigen in your samples, we calibrate them to a standard curve. Each protein has a specified range of detection and sensitivity. All standard curves are determined by our scientists and custom to the target of interest. The curve displays the sensitivity, which is the lowest concentration point we can statistically distinguish from a zero. The dilution factor of your sample should be determined empirically and calculated to fit this range. If this is your first step, we've got you. Our plates come with removable strips that can be resealed and frozen back. All you have to keep in mind is that each run requires a duplicate standard curve. Our kit comes with enough lyophilized standard for two separate runs. Here are a few run options. For demonstration purposes, we are going to show a full plate. For human IL-18, we constitute the standard at 5,000 picograms per mil. We will then dilute the sample so the top concentration is 75 picograms per mil.
Next, carry out a 2/5 dilution all the way until standard 7, so the bottom concentration is 0.31 picograms per mil. We will also include a 0 or blank as a control. Our samples for this demonstration are serum and plasma, so we are going to use ADA as a diluent. If your samples are cell culture, use ADB. Reconstitute the lyophilized mixture with 400 microliters and ensure it is thoroughly mixed in a homogeneous mixture. Next, prepare the tubes with the indicated volumes. For standard 1, add 788 microliters of ADA. In standards 2 through 7 and the control, add 300 microliters. Good laboratory practices are always to spin volumes down prior to diluting. When you mix, it will be with the full volume. This helps with our precision. Once this is complete, you are ready to start the standard curve. Pipette 12 microliters of stock solution into standard 1. Mix thoroughly and gently with repeated pipetting at least 10 times. Eject the tip, carry 200 microliters from standard 1 to standard 2, mixing thoroughly and gently again with repeated pipetting at least 10 times. Eject the tip and repeat this step until standard 7. Eject the tip each time so the high concentration of tube 1 does not influence the concentration of tube 7 incidentally. Keep the zero separate to prevent accidental passage from the standard. Add 100 microliter of standard and sample and duplicate to each well according to a plate map. Get a new pipette tip between each standard. Once you've added your standard, you can add your diluted samples. Keep track of the plate map for every run. Ensure there are no bubbles, as the capture antibody should be able to interact with the homogeneous mixture. Seal the ELISA plate to prevent contamination. If you are running less strips, you can use plastic wrap. Cover and incubate at room temperature for 2.5 hours. If you have low signal, you can incubate at 4 degrees overnight. Many times, this is recommended. During the incubation, the target protein will be captured with high specificity and low cross-reactivity. To prepare the detection antibody, always spin the volume down first, then add 100 microliters of ADB to the vial. One tube is enough for 6 strips. We are using a full plate, so go ahead and reconstitute both. The final concentration of detection antibody is target-specific, so the total volume needed for all targets is calculated as 1 milliliter per strip. If you are using 4 strips, it's 4 milliliters, 6 strips is 6 milliliters, and 12 strips is 12 milliliters. Because we are using a full plate, the total volume used will be 12 milliliters. Regardless of sample type, the dilution volume is with ADB, and you will not use ADA again. Detection antibody of IL-18 requires an ADX dilution, so we will add 150 microliters. Once samples are done incubating and you are ready to add your detection antibody, you can go ahead and wash your plate. We use a plate washer, but many times, if you want to minimize background, it is best to pipette wash, especially if your neighbor's plate washer hasn't been cleaned in a while. Pipette washing is completed by adding 300 microliters of wash buffer to each well. With either wash technique, make sure you remove the excess liquid thoroughly. Make sure the detection antibody is a homogeneous mixture by using a vortex. The detection antibody should be the same temperature as the plate prior to plating. Add 100 microliters to each well and make sure there are no bubbles. Cover and incubate for 1 hour. The biotinylated detection antibody will find that bound antigen with high specificity. The total volume of HRP is calculated in the same way as the detection antibody. We are using a full plate, so we will use 12 milliliters of ADB. Spin down and mix the HRP prior to use. Our target specific HRP dilution is 300x, so we will add 40 microliters. HRP should be the same temperature as the plate prior to plating. Once the detection antibody is done incubating, wash the plate again. Make sure you thoroughly remove the wash buffer. Homogenize the mixture with a vortex. Add 100 microliters per well with no bubbles. Incubate covered at room temperature for 45 minutes. After this incubation, this is the last time you will wash and dry. Add 100 microliters of TMB substrate. HRP bound to the detection antibody will turn that substrate into a colorimetric product. Therefore, the bound HRP is directly related to the color intensity in each well. This is a light sensitive reaction, so you will incubate in the dark for 30 minutes. If you have low signal, increase the incubation time. To stop the reaction, add 50 microliters of stop solution. Be careful, it is sulfuric acid. This reaction will turn the solution from blue to yellow. It is important to read immediately, as too long of a reaction can cause precipitates. The color intensity is calculated as optical density, or the ability to block light. The higher the OD, the higher the concentration. To calculate the standard curve and calibrate your samples against it, use the analysis tool found on the website.
Now, you just have to write up your study and publish. Easy, right? Thank you for watching. Contact technical support at this email if you have any questions regarding our risk-free guarantee or your first trial ELISA kit for $99.